It's magic. What's up, money geeks? Mr. V here. Welcome to another video, guys. So in today's video, I want to kind of walk you guys through how I go about picking the stocks that I invest in. Before we actually get started, guys, if you're new to the channel, we'll talk about how to earn money, how to save money, how to invest and build wealth. So if that's something that interests you, go ahead and hit that subscribe button and your notification bell so you don't miss out on new content. So I've been getting a lot of questions from some of you guys asking me like how I do choose the stocks that I invest in or the companies that I invest in. To me, it's a very tricky question because people have different investment styles and people are looking for different things in the stock market. But so in this case, I'm going to talk based on my personal experience and what I consider before I go into investing. So again, and I'm going to focus solely on long-term investing. So there is a different strategy to pick stocks that I can invest in, maybe for a swing trade, or I can invest in day trading. Because I mean, you guys know I do day trading. I just kind of like a side hustle. I haven't gone full-time with day trading, but I can. That's choosing the stocks to invest or to trade is different from choosing the stocks to invest long-term. So today, again, we're going to talk about how I choose stocks that I invest in long-term. And again, let me kind of break this down. I have two accounts. I have a cash account and I have a margin account, both with WEBULL. And so if you're new and you want to learn more about WEBULL, I have a playlist that I'm going to hook up here that you can definitely go check it out. I use them for my cash account and my margin account. And so my cash account is where I invest long term, and my margin account is where I do day trading and sometimes swing trading, but mostly 98% is day trading. So choosing companies that I want to invest in long terms, I consider three main things. Number one is that company solving a problem? Are they really providing a solution that's needed? So I'll use an example of a company like Tesla, which we all know. When Tesla came into the scene, they were solving a major problem. They were looking into the future and saying like, hey, what if fossil fuel ran out? What would happen to all the cars that we have today? Those cars would just sit there because they run on fossil fuel. So they started building cars that don't require fossil fuel. So that's solving a major problem that could potentially happen. The other one was that the fossil fuel that we burned, a lot of people complain about that it does really do damage to the environment. So how can you solve that? Let's find cars or build cars that don't emit CO2, which would solve that environmental problem. So you see, they were solving a major problem. And another company to look at, which again, you guys know, is Amazon. Amazon started selling used books. For those of you that don't even know, they've grown so big today that people don't even realize they started selling books. So imagine back in the days, you go into college, you buy a textbook for $150, and then when you're done with that class, that book is useless. Amazon find a way to give you a little bit of money for that book. So if you bought a book for $150, they pay you $30 and then turn around and sell it for $60 or $70 to somebody that needs the book. So the person buying it at $70, or I'm paying, I'm getting at 50% off, and the person that actually sold it, it's like, hey, I made some extra money with my used books, which is good. So it was a win-win. So, but now they've actually morphed into a lot of things. But that's how you find companies that are solving a problem. So you can look in different sectors. So you can look in technology, you can look in healthcare, look in the environment. I mean, there's a lot of sectors that look in the financial sector. You can look at all these different sectors and find companies that are breaking ground, solving really tough problems that we have and we don't have solutions for. And those will be, that would be a great company to start really putting on your watch list. The next thing that I want you to consider choosing, again, companies for long term is, are they scalable? Is there scalability in this company? So again, I'll use the example of Tesla. When Tesla started, they started building electric cars. But now they've scaled into building batteries, building solar panels that people can actually install in their house, which is kind of cool. So there's an opportunity out there for them to scale and continue to grow the business. So from a long-term perspective, you started with a company that built cars. Now they're building solar panels and now they're building batteries. So what happens? They are increasing the market size and increasing profit and increasing your value in the company. and that's how you make money long term. And last but not the least is proof of concept. So if you take a company that comes up and has these ideas, and yep, it's good, they tell you they're solving a problem, which is good, they show you like, hey, we're gonna scale, that's good, but can you show me that this is doable? So if you can show a good proof of concept, then that's how I would consider that this is a great company. And then one other thing that I want you to just do is, first, invest in things that you know and understand. Don't go, if you don't understand something, please, it might be a good investment, it might turn out to be a good investment, but you are just gambling. You're not really investing because you know. So invest in things that you know. If you work in tech, if you have a company that you use their product every day, let's say you use Oracle database on a daily basis, you know that other companies are using it because you work in tech and you talk to other tech people, then that would be a company that you want to start considering invest in, because like, hey, people love this particular database, they're using it all over the place, so you know that's a company that people are using it. The reason I'm using a database because I work in tech. Or if you work in healthcare and you see there's a new company that comes up and is doing something that people enjoy, you think that they're changing the way healthcare is going to be in the future, and you hear other people in that space talking about it, do some research, and that might be a company you can invest in. And in some cases, it's just talking to people in your family, ask them about what they do and what kind of the tools they use and what companies supply those tools, and you can see it, and then that's how you can go about researching and picking this company. So again, guys, just a quick recap here. So before you invest or how to choose companies to invest, I want you, the first thing is for you to just take a step back. Make sure this company that you're investing in is solving a particular problem. Number two is that, is it scalable? And finally, number three, is there a proof of concept? Can you show that what you think about, it really works? Can you take this to the market? So that would be the way I would approach it. So let me know in the comment section if you have some other ideas or other ways in which you go about picking the companies that you invest in. So question of the day, what are you considering before you invest in a company? Let me know in the comment section. Again, like I said, guys, I do use WEBULL for investing, and right now WEBULL is running a promotion where they give you two free stocks. The first one will be between $2 and $250, and then the second one from $12 to about $1,400. So I'm gonna put the link in the description. Definitely go check them out and see if WEBULL is a platform for you. And as always, guys, stay motivated.